Hello, I'm Lucas Kitchen, and in this episode, we're going to learn how to get consistent characters in Midjourney. If this is new to you, then I highly suggest that you get in there and have some fun. Now, the AI generation bot that I like is Midjourney, although I've tried others. I really like Midjourney. I like how they've dialed it in. It's very artistic. It's beautiful. And so that's what we're going to explore. Now, before we get into it, I want to make a deal with you. So I'm giving you my knowledge for free because I want to make a trade with you. I want a moment of your time at the end of this video to tell you about something that's very important to me. So please stick around for that. Also, if you want to get access to the specific prompts that I used in this video and other assets that go along with it, you can do that by going to freegrace.in/Midjourney characters, all one word. I'll show you some examples that I've worked on to try to get consistent characters. So take a look at my screen here. This is a series I did for a sci-fi book that I'm working on, and I wanted consistent characters. So here's the bad guy, Admiral Koenig Strafe, and Strafe needed to look scary. He needed to look dangerous. Now, here's the thing about this image is there really are only two separate faces. I know you see three, but if you look close, I've used Photoshop to place one of the faces on another. And this is the first rule, that if you want consistent characters, the AI generation bots are not quite ready to give us just exacting characters. So you're probably going to have to be comfortable in Photoshop or some other equivalent. Let's take a look at another. This is Madame Electra Styx. Yet again, some Photoshop work here, merging separate images that Midjourney gave me. But there's basically three faces here, but two of them are highly merged in Photoshop. This one I was really excited about. This is one of my main characters, Captain Mariana Sokolov. And I felt like she was pretty consistent. And I'll tell you how we got the consistency with her face in a moment. But if you look really close, you will notice they're not exact, but they're close enough for what I'm trying to create. This is another character, and you'll notice there's just one, and that's because I tried and tried and tried, but I could not get the same character out of this one. And that's because I was running up against the limitations of AI generation. And this character is a great example. He is highly specific. He has a mechanized arm. He has a specific age. He has a specific look. And so getting multiple of him in that looked exact was very difficult. And so it's good to know the limitations at the moment. Here's another. This is one of my main characters, Eustace. And you'll notice that he turned out probably the most consistent. I figured out a certain method and used it with him. Here's another one of the character sheets that I created for a character named Enzo. And he's fairly consistent as well. And so he turned out pretty well. So let's jump into Midjourney, and I'll show you a couple of different ways to get consistent characters. Now, to start with, I want to make a point that if you are starting with a blank canvas, it might be worth thinking about what Midjourney is good at and play to its strengths. Now, I learned something in the last video that I did about creating a children's book. You see, I asked the kids what kind of characters in the children's book would they like to see. And one of the children told me that they wanted to see a puppy. And I thought, oh man, how boring, but I just went with it. And so I began to work with that prompt, and I used a chocolate Labrador as the prompt, and then I gave it different expressions, and it worked beautifully. Now, I actually used two different methods to get consistent characters in that last video. Let me show you an example. And by the way, you can download this ebook for free. You can find that link. But in this ebook, you'll see consistent characters. So let's take a look. So this is Fluff. Now, this is what I learned about creating consistent characters, is that before you begin your story, if you can pick a type of character that the AI generation bot can do really well, then you're going to save yourself a lot of trouble. And it turns out that there are so many billions of pictures of puppies that the AI image generation software does really well at creating specific kind of puppies. And that's probably true across the board with any kind of animals that are out there. So if you want to make a story about animals and have consistent characters, you're doing yourself a favor if they're not really odd and really creative characters. And so consequently, Midjourney was able to create this consistent character with this dog over and over with a lot of different expressions because it knows how to do puppies really well. And so I told it, do a chocolate Labrador, and it did a fantastic job. It just can do that. If you want consistent characters and you can pick a character that that the AI can do well, like an animal, then it can do those really well. Now, another example of a consistent character, which I used a different method, was this one, this old man. So you'll notice that this old man appears a few times. Here, he has a different expression than he has here. Now, the way to do this is actually to use reference material. And so what I did is, this was my original image. And then with Photoshop, I went in and I chopped his head out, made a small it's kind of thumbnail size version of his head. And then I put that into Midjourney and began to add prompts to it. I began to play around with it. And not everything it gave me was usable, but we just continued to re-roll it. Now, what you'll notice here is that there are differences. Okay, so look at his hat, for instance. Oh, now his hat has got a tag on it and it's got these other little things. You'll notice that his shirt is a little different and his suspenders are a little different, but they're close enough to work. And that's just the way that Midjourney works. It's not an exact match, but you can get kind of in the ballpark. I'll show you another oddity about this image. This image looks pretty good, but take a look at his left hand. He has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 fingers on that hand, probably 8 because you wouldn't see his thumb. And this is something that Midjourney and all of the AI bots still are not doing well. It's fingers. They just really struggle with doing consistent hands. And so we're still kind of waiting around for some fixes for that. So, first rule for getting consistent characters, pick a character that the AI can do well. And you'll have to experiment a little bit with this. But if you want to do a story about a giraffe or a dog or a monkey, you know, be as specific as you can when you create those characters in the prompts. And then it can generally do that pretty well. So that's the first rule. The second rule is use reference. So once you get a character out of Midjourney or your AI generation bot, chop it down to just the part you want to use and then feed it back into the AI generation system and then begin to make variations on that and you will get some consistent characters. Now, there's a third way to get consistent characters that I used on other projects and I'll show you how that works. Use famous faces. That's right, to use famous faces. Now, here's the problem. Let's imagine that I want to make a character that looks like Brad Pitt. Let's say Brad Pitt as a fantasy warrior. So, here's what it gave us. It gave us these amazing images of, yeah, Brad Pitt. I mean, it looks like Brad Pitt. And the reason why it can do Brad Pitt is because there's so many millions of pictures of Brad Pitt's amazing face. And so it can do that really well. But we obviously have a problem. We don't have the copyright authority to use Brad Pitt's face. In fact, I probably shouldn't even be using it in this video, but this is just for teaching. So sorry, Brad, but we're using your face. So here's the thing. You can't do this and get away with it, right? I mean, you're gonna be laughed at if you put a famous person in your your production or your comic book or your children's book or whatever it is. But we can use this method to get something consistent. So here's what I started to do, is to use a mix of famous people that isn't one or the other. So let's try this. We'll put in the prompt, a perfect mix of Brad Pitt and Chris Pratt as a fantasy warrior. Now, what we're doing here is we're telling the AI to mix the features of Brad Pitt and Chris Pratt. Now, if you use two characters that look very, very different, then the results are going to be varied. But if you use two humans, two famous humans that have somewhat similar characteristics, then it can make a pretty consistent amalgam of those two. So let's see what it gives us. Okay, here's what it gave us. It's really interesting. There's some really interesting pieces in there. However, on a few of them, it gave us two boxes, two separate characters. So, and this is an obvious thing that can happen. So, one of the things that you want to do is you want to give a clarifier to help it understand what you're trying to say. So, instead of saying a perfect mix of Brad Pitt and Chris Pratt, we need to say we want one man that is a perfect mix of these, and usually that will help solve this problem. So let's try that. So our prompt now is a fantasy warrior who is the perfect mix of Brad Pitt and Chris Pratt. Let's see if this solves our two-panel problem. Okay, now we have something that's beginning to look usable. However, some of them still look a little too much like Brad Pitt to me. And so what you want to do then, if it looks too much like one person or the other, it probably means that using a different human actor would be a little bit better. Now, none of these look exactly like Brad Pitt or Chris Pratt, but they tend to look more like Brad Pitt, and that might be because there's more photo reference of Brad Pitt than there is Chris Pratt. Sorry, Chris, but that's probably the reality. He's very good looking. So maybe we use somebody other than Brad Pitt. And here's where it begins to get interesting. If you use characters that are what we would call character actors who have unique faces, then you begin to get more varied looks. And so a couple that I really like that I've used for some characters are Michael Shannon, who has a very intense look, and a guy named Willem Dafoe. And so let's see what we get when we change out Brad Pitt and Chris Pratt for those two character actors. Okay, so here's the prompt that I've put in. A digital painting of a space warrior who is the perfect mix of Michael Shannon and Willem Dafoe in space. And then I put in --AR:16:9. So let me just explain a couple of things. That first line that says a digital painting of, that's going to dictate our style. That's going to recognize that it wants us, that I want it to give us a little bit of a different style. And then that tag at the end is what's called the aspect ratio. And so if I know this is going to go into a video, for instance, the standard aspect ratio of a video is widescreen, which is called 16:9 aspect ratio. And so that AR stands for aspect ratio, and you put that in and it'll give you that shape. Now, there's lots of other tags that you can use with Midjourney. Maybe we'll do a video on those in the future, but let's see what this does. Okay, so we got something that I'm pretty excited about. Take a look at these. So, you'll notice that we have a fairly consistent character. Little variations, but I think at a quick glance, it looks pretty similar on each of these faces. And so even at this point, you begin to see that we have some consistency. Now, you can add some specifics that can bring it even to some tighter constraints, like age and, you know, the situation that they're in, of course. And so this is one of the, in my opinion, best ways to get consistent characters. However, there is a caveat. I noticed that over time, the consistency of these characters changes. So it brings into question whether it's really consistent. So here's what I mean. I made some characters. I spent a day making some characters a few months ago, and then I used those exact same prompts a few months later, and the characters didn't look like the characters I had a few months ago. I'm not exactly sure why that is. I think it probably has something to do with the fact that maybe through updates, they're continuing to teach the image generation model, or maybe they're tweaking things. I don't know. But if you want consistent characters, this is kind of the fourth rule. You're going to want to make all the characters you need in a pretty tight space of time. Okay, so you don't want to say, oh, I'll finish this up 6 months from now. No, the model may be really different then, and you may really struggle to get it to be consistent from now till then. So you're going to want to make the characters kind of all together. So let's just review. The first way to get consistent characters is to pick characters that the model can do really well, like animals with specifics, like a chocolate Labrador or an adult giraffe or something like that. The model can do those really well. The next is to use reference. So if I was to take one of these images, drop it back into Midjourney, and then tell it to make variations on that, you begin to get consistent characters that way, with variations, but they're more consistent than if you don't do that. Third is to use reference material that the model has lots of reference on. So that would be mixing faces of famous people. Then the fourth thing is to create consistent characters within a tight time frame so that you don't run into the model changing and becoming something completely different. So those are a few points on how to get consistent characters. Now, it all comes with this huge proviso that it is really impossible to get absolutely consistent characters in any of the image generation models as of yet, though we are getting closer. So right now, we're kind of hacking it together. We're trying to figure out ways to do workarounds because the system is not oriented toward giving us precisely consistent characters. But I can assure you that the engineers behind these things know that it's something people want, and they'll solve it. Now, so that's how I get the consistent characters that you've seen coming out of my studio. I'd love to hear what you're doing to get consistent characters. If you've got some other ideas, please let us know. People are discovering new ways to do this all the time. Please, let's have a conversation about it. Leave a comment or send me a message. I'd love to hear about it. Now, I told you earlier in the video that I want to take a minute at the end of this video to talk to you about something that's very important to me. And that minute has come. One of the things that I use these art tools for is to share biblical ideas, to talk about the concepts that I find in Scripture with people. And I use art and some of these cutting-edge tools to do that. And the reason for that is because I am absolutely convinced that around 2,000 years ago, God came to the world in flesh, and he died for our sins so that he could offer us eternal life. So I love sharing that message with people, and I love doing it with these various formats in art and audio and video. And I hope that maybe you would consider taking a look at our website, where we have lots of content that both is very artistic, but also has to do with faith in Jesus for the free gift of eternal life. You can find our website at freegrace.in. If you go there, you'll begin to see we have all kinds of stuff for you to enjoy and to think a little bit more about Jesus's offer that he extended to all people on the earth. So, that is my pitch for you. I hope that you'll consider that. Hope that you'll take that to heart. And I hope that you have fun in Midjourney creating. And I hope to hear from you. I'll see you soon.